Are Toyota Tacoma recalls evening the playing field? Good morning, Krista.
Good morning.
Good morning, Louie. That's a good doggy. Who's a good doggy? Cold start. Looking for a new truck, right? I mean, you know, it used to be that the Toyota Tacoma was heralded for its reliability and its quality, right? I mean, it was kind of a no-brainer. And I think that kind of made the Toyota Tacoma kind of the upper echelon, right? It kind of had that reputation as being bulletproof and kind of put it at the top of the heap, if you will. And I think that's why Toyota has been able to get a little bit more money out of the Tacomas, to be quite honest. You know, they have that reputation or that feeling that you're getting something better, so they charge more money for it. But is that true anymore? You know, recently we've had a few recalls kind of putting into question the quality and reliability of the Toyota Tacoma. You know, we have the ongoing frame thing. That's been going on for years, and I don't believe there's any real evidence yet that Toyota has tackled that problem. You know, Toyota, it was so bad that Toyota is replacing frames for free. Now, you know there's a big problem when a manufacturer is going to replace something like that for free. I mean, it isn't cheap for them to do, right? They have the cost of the frame as well as the labor to do it. Then we had the, and I'm speaking from my own experience, we had the brake master cylinder problem. There was a big recall on that for at least the 2018s. I had mine replaced. That was a thrilling and exciting 2 to 3 hours at the dealership. And then most recently, we have the fuel pump debacle, right? Kind of started out as a rumor, then it became kind of a TSB kind of thing, a service bulletin, and then they issued a full bore recall where they were replacing some number, I can't remember, quite a few. And then it's been expanded most recently to include 5.4 million vehicles. Now, that's not just the Toyota Tacoma. It includes the Tundra and a bunch of other ones. I did a video on that. If you're interested in that, I'll leave a link down below. You can check it out. But this tarnishes the reputation, at least in my eyes, for the Toyota Tacoma. You know, it used to be you only had to worry about that kind of stuff with all the other brands, right? The Fords and the Jeeps. You know, I have a Jeep Gladiator, and it's had its share of quirks, I must admit, so far in my young ownership of it. You know, I've had a radio black screen, I've had a check engine light, I've had failure of the auto stop system, but nothing that's debilitating to the truck, or in other words, nothing that's going to strand you anywhere. That's not true with this fuel pump problem with the Toyota Tacoma. You know, in the notices that I've seen, Toyota states that the truck could stall, and it can stall at any time. You could be driving down the freeway and it can stall and it may not restart. They even went as far as to say that it could cause an accident. Now that's pretty serious, right? I mean, if you and your significant other and your significant little others are all in the truck and you're cruising down the freeway and it stalls, it could be a problem. So there's a big safety concern there. And I think that's what kind of differentiates this problem for me from the issues I've experienced in the Gladiator, in that, you know, the check engine light going off in the Gladiator is not going to cause it to stall, or maybe the auto stop failure. You're still going to have use of the truck. I've never had any issue with it not starting or dying on me in the middle of the freeway. A big problem with the Toyota Tacoma. So are these Tacoma recalls and little issues that seem to keep coming up tarnishing their reputation? Is it evening the playing field between mid-sized trucks? You know, right now, it's probably not a great time for these things to be happening, right? I mean, you have all of these other entries re-emerging in the mid-sized truck market. You know, we have the Ford Ranger back now, of course, the new Jeep Gladiator. We have the Chevy Colorado. We have the Nissan Frontier. So it's really opening up, and I've even heard that Dodge or Ram, I'm not quite sure who they are anymore, is going to be coming back out with the Dakota, which is another mid-size entry. So the mid-size market is getting quite full, if you will. So it's not a great time for Toyota to start stumbling when it comes to quality and reliability, because I do believe that evens the playing field. You know, I mean, if you're looking at them across the line and Toyota doesn't have that superior rating or feel to it because it's bulletproof, well, then anything's game, right? I mean, you kind of flip the quarter and pick which one you're going to buy, because if they're all even, you're taking your chance either way, right? No longer is the Toyota Tacoma the cream of the crop, that bulletproof truck that you can pay or have to pay a little bit more for and not have to worry about these problems. So I think Toyota needs to get on the ball, man. They need to solve these issues, take care of these problems. And I will say, and I've mentioned this before, you know, the true mark of a good manufacturer is how they handle problems once they arise. I mean, all manufacturers are awesome when there aren't any problems, right? But when problems arise, how do they handle them, you know? Do they come out? Do they admit that there's something wrong and then fix it in a timely manner with a product or a part that isn't going to fail again? And there's a little controversy out there about what Toyota is doing with these fuel pumps. I have heard that they're merely replacing them with another fuel pump that is the same as the one that's causing the problems. Almost in essence hoping or rolling the dice that you're not going to have problems with that replacement part. What the heck? I haven't heard anything that says that Toyota has come out with a new and improved fuel pump and that you're not going to have the same potential problems with your replacement. That's not good. That's not good at all. So anyway, I was thinking about this. You know, I had to make a trip to Lowe's this morning. Of course, I brought you guys with me. Had to get a little bit of paint. You can probably hear it rattling around in here. It's a spruce green for a little Jeep Gladiator mod I got going on. Check that out if you're interested to see what I'm doing with green paint on my Gladiator. But anyway, I wanted to talk about this a little bit because I've been thinking about it. You know, down the road, I'll be in the market for another truck someday, years from now, probably, maybe. But is the Tacoma still a viable option for me? You know, is the playing field leveled out? And I think at the moment, and hopefully this will be taken care of before I ever get to needing another truck. But I think the playing field is level right now because of these recalls and things that the Toyota Tacoma has been having. Anyway, let me know what you think. Leave a comment. You know, do you still feel secure in buying a Toyota Tacoma? Are you confident that you're not going to have any issues? I'd be curious to know. Also, real quick, check out my other channel if you're interested. It is Robmotive JT, all about my 2020 Jeep Gladiator. Don't forget to click that notification bell so that you don't miss out on any upcoming videos. And do me a favor, smash that subscribe button on the way out. Thanks for watching. Stay safe out there.